Widespread corruption and poor service delivery of public good remain a challenge not only at central but even at local government level. This is because information about service delivery accountability is preserved of the district political and civil service leaders. This creates a situation where rural population treat the provision of service as a gift of favor from their leaders.
We decided to come out with a project empowering local communities to monitor district service delivery through ICTs to make sure that the community of Northern Uganda are empowered to put their leaders to task to account for the services that they are offering to the community.
Women of Uganda Network, WUGNET, has focused on increasing women participation in decision-making, policy-making, engaging and influencing policies to be gender sensitive. In the five districts of Northern Uganda, namely Gulu, Apach, Kole, Oyam, and Amuru, WUGNET has identified women's groups and community-based organizations at village and parish levels with the intention of growing their ability, monitor service delivery, and fight corruption.
ICTs are very many. All of you know, we have a radio, we have a mobile phone. Radios are our small ones, even on our phones, those are radios. But we also have a radio station.
In Oyam, Apach, and Kole, Lillian Marse Apio is the information assistant for WUGNET. She gives her progress report.
Mobilizing the people to make them know about the project, where we actually had to raise awareness about the project that was done. The second thing was training the communities, building their capacity in the use of ICT. Third was forming the voluntary social accountability committee to monitor the services in their communities. We have held an information sharing workshop. So we had to invite in the district officials to come and answer some of the queries, since it's really very hard for them to reach the communities.
In Amuru district, Pegene Morris cites a number of poorly done service projects.
So there's a problem with NOSAF, because from there, we have the money already in the community account, and up to now, we have not yet even seen the money. You find that the district officials, like NOSAF desk officer, they are intending to bring their relative in order to work on that, which is very bad. Even in Amuru, the district officials, they are not even reporting to the working place, especially on Monday and Friday. They don't report at all to the working place.
WUGNET has had a remarkable effect in Gulu district. Gilbert Egwell, the project assistant in charge of Gulu and Amuru, talks highly of a successful project.
Community used to fear their leaders, but today they are working together. They are holding their leaders accountable for the action they are taking in terms of service delivery in their community. Our community used not to know the importance of ICT. They used to use ICT for sending greetings over the radio, requesting for songs. But today they are using ICT innovatively and strategically to document, and then after documenting, report.
At Peche Bridge, it takes up to a week for the people to cross this point when the rains start. It's known that money was released to work on the bridge, but this has not been done up to today. 55-year-old Achai Paul has lived in this area for 8 years.
During the rain season, the problem was about the pupil, school pupil. They cannot patch. Secondly, this water also can block those of the border man, civil servants from the village when they're taking their water, their things, the market.
Kibota Betty from Peche Division says the health services in her division are wanting.
We found there was a problem mainly with main hospital, where we expect the government to provide us with enough drugs. You find that people do come, they are given Panadol, later on they are referred to clinics. Inadequate staffing, We look at also at attitude of the workers. We find some of them really need disciplinary.
In Apache District, Ibuje Sub-County, Amute Harriet says parents collected building fees for a certain school, but up to today, the school's management has not accounted for the money.
At times, we collected money for building fees. After collecting all this money, we don't see the accountability. There's a misuse, the misuse of this money.
In Peche Powell Central Division, a borehole was constructed to serve 500 people. This borehole is not functional up to today.
We have been looking for a technician, but they came and they said, this one you need amount of money, more than about 500,000.
Despite the above strides, the project has met some challenges along the way.
The areas where the project is being implemented are totally rural areas where computers cannot be accessed, mobile phones, the networks are not steady. The other thing is some of them, when they try to call into the radio, especially during the talk show, it also becomes hard for them to go through because the line is always busy. The other challenge is some leaders always hide information from these voluntary social accountability committees.
All in all, the SPIDA-funded project on empowering local people and community to demand for improved delivery services through the use of ICTs has had a positive outcome. Corruption.